Our next speaker is Caitlin Shortell. She's one of the attorneys who recently prevailed in the Hamby versus Parnell lawsuit that opened up marriage in Alaska to same-sex couples. So please help me welcome Caitlin Shortell.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. I'm Caitlin Shortell. In 1978, I was a first grader at Chugach Optional, not too far from here. I remember how every morning we would gather to sing the Alaska flag song. We learned the words on a giant flip chart, and I still remember them to this day. I loved the imagery of the starry sky, the great North Star, its beacon bright. But my favorite part was the part that says, Alaska's flag, may it mean to you. I didn't know then that the flag was designed by an Alaskan native kid named Benny Benson. But from then on, I've always loved Alaska as my home and a place that I feel I belong, even when later I learned that we're not all as equal as others. I grew up to be a civil rights lawyer, and I filed the case of Hamby versus Walker, the constitutional lawsuit that challenged and overturned the Alaska state ban on same-sex marriage in 2014. Our fight for marriage equality in Alaska is part of a bigger struggle for equality and human rights. My story starts way before anyone in this room was born, because our struggles for equality rely on the work of previous generations. But I only have 8 minutes, so I'm going to transport you to a few key moments of the work for equality that I do in our community. In June of 2013, the US Supreme Court struck down the Federal Defense of Marriage Act, and in another case allowed same-sex marriages to continue in California. This changed the legal landscape and made it possible for us to think about challenging Alaska's ban on same-sex marriage. Alaska's ban was one of the first, if not the first, in the nation, and one of the last to go. In response to laws attacking LGBT people, families, and rights, a nationwide movement for LGBT equality ensued. This movement took place on the streets, in pride marches, in legislatures, in city councils, in schools and courtrooms, and in the hearts and minds of our fellow humans, from Anchorage all the way to the Capitol and the US Supreme Court. Court cases involving LGBT rights made their way to the US Supreme Court in the same way that they did in other movements previously for women, African Americans, Native Americans, disabled Americans, and others. Around the nation in the LGBT cases, lawsuits were filed to challenge state same-sex marriage bans that had been instated in many states. Our team in Alaska brought one of the last lawsuits to challenge a state ban. So like I said when I told you about the flag song, I was born and raised in Alaska, and I had worked as a civil rights attorney here. As lead hearing attorney at the Alaska State Commission for Human Rights, I fought for complainants who were discriminated against and harassed and retaliated against based on categories like sex, race, nationality, disability. But I couldn't help any clients who suffered discrimination based on sexuality, sexual orientation, or gender identity, even though this affected me personally. I'm bisexual, and I received unequal spousal benefits in my job at the state. I watched as an initiative to add sexual orientation to the non-discrimination ordinance in Anchorage was defeated by hate and vetoed by Mayor Sullivan in 2009. During the hearings for that ordinance in that chamber right over there, busloads of people from inside and outside of Anchorage came to testify that they wanted the freedom to discriminate against LGBT people, and the mayor gleaned from that there was not sufficient evidence of discrimination. Anyone who's been witness to these events in our history knows different, and the courts have vindicated that experience. On June 26, 2013, the US Supreme Court struck down the Defense of Marriage Act, a federal law defining marriage as a man and a woman, and ruled in a different case that same-sex marriages could continue in the state of California. So on that very day, I put a word out on Facebook saying, I'm looking for couples who would like to challenge the state marriage ban. What happened next was a moment in my life that I can only liken it to teleportation. It felt like we transported ourselves from a moment of an era of inequality to an era of equality. On October 12th of last year, after we filed a motion for summary judgment and did an oral argument, myself and my co-counsel, Heather Gardner and Allison Mendel, we won our case. District Judge Tim Burgess issued a decision that declared the marriage laws unconstitutional and a violation of both the equal protection and due process. So what that meant was that the judge ordered an injunction, ordered the state to stop enforcing these laws from that moment forward and to issue marriage licenses. After a brief period where the state tried to get courts to put that on hold, the effect, actually the injunction and allowing marriages to go forward, we won, and marriages have been going forward. So hundreds of people have gotten married as a result of our case. I think I read that in early 2015, it was something like over close to 700 that had married. Unfortunately, the governor, our new Governor Walker, has maintained the appeal of the decision, but same-sex marriage is legal in Alaska, and we're waiting for the Supreme Court of the United States to affirm that decision in late June of this year. This is monumental social change, but we're not finished yet. We're still not equal. State law doesn't address hate crimes based on gender identity or sexual orientation, and there's no protection against discrimination based on sexual orientation or gender identity in state or local law. Although Governor Knowles made an executive order to protect state employees from discrimination in their employment in 2002, there are no other provisions. There have been efforts, as those of us who have been here know, from when I was something like 3 years old to the 2009 attempt in Anchorage, and again now in this legislative session, Andy Josephson filed a bill, HB 19, to add sexual orientation to the protected class categories in the state human rights law. But so we have, then there are other sponsors, we have allies in the legislature, but there is a greater majority of lawmakers who do not recognize the priority of Alaskans for equality for all. So I urge everyone, if you see the value in our common equality and humanity, to make sure that your representatives know how you feel, and that's a priority for you. On the issue of discrimination, I have, just because I'm constantly trying to cause trouble, I have recently contacted both the state and the Anchorage commissions that accept discrimination complaints, and was told that even though the EEOC is now made it a strategic enforcement priority to take claims involving sexual orientation and gender identity discrimination, and they're taking those as sex discrimination claims that they see that are protected under Title VII, neither our local AERC or ASCHR are taking complaints on that same basis. They have given me an indication that it may be a case-by-case basis, and so look for more on that in the future. So. But currently, we don't. If an Alaskan has a claim of employment discrimination based on sexual orientation or gender identity, they really need to call the federal EEOC. So I'm using this as my platform to, you know, let everyone know that there's often a lot of confusion about that, and people really aren't being told, hey, you could just call the federal agency and make your complaint there. So I urge you to do that, or tell your friends if they're being. They're subject to discrimination. So in my lifetime, and particularly in 2014, we've traveled light years in this struggle, but there's no question that Alaskan LGBT people suffer discrimination. We still have work to do to realize that dream that made me so misty when I was in first grade about what Alaska means to me, which is a home where we all belong and have equality. Thank you.